You're listening to the Ty D. Fanzio Show on Idiot Radio. Taking it to the edge. And
baby, let's go!
Yo, baby.
Hello.
It's the Todd DeFazio Show. We are broadcasting live.
Woo!
Now, when I say that, we today are really broadcasting live, Brett.
I love it. It's the only way to have us, a live mic. I love it. Right for me. I'm telling you. Loving it.
Well, we're broadcasting live at three different places. We're broadcasting live on idiotradio.net. We're broadcasting live on our Idiot Radio app. And we're also broadcasting live on Facebook. But it's not our traditional Facebook page. It's our Facebook group. So
we have a group?
Yep, the Todd DeFazio Facebook, Todd DeFazio Show Facebook group.
I didn't even know I was a part of that one. That's awesome.
I think you're a member of it, bro.
But, I'm like the vice president. I don't even know.
So, yeah, we're broadcasting all over the place. We got the cameras rolling.
Fantastic.
Also, we have live phones today. So if you are tuning in and you are listening or watching live.
And trust me, you want to call in.
Call us. 412-407-SHOWS. The phone number gets you on the phone with, you can talk to Brett.
Yeah. Or you. Yeah.
Well, we got a special guest today. Hannah's still on vacation. I've seen all the great pictures. She'll have some great stories when she comes back.
Oh, I can't wait.
But a good friend of mine filled in for Han today. My buddy Scott's here.
Hello.
Scott Whiteclaw.
Scott Whiteclaw. That's a new one.
Get them paws on the claws, brother.
Is hanging out with us today. One of my good buddies. One of my drinking partners.
Still boozing. Get in the claw, though.
So, Scott, welcome to the show. Before the show, this is your first podcast.
Oh, it is.
You ever done? So, welcome. And it's a little different than what a normal podcast or, you know, what normal people perceive normal podcasts to be.
It's a safe zone. You feel comfortable saying anything. You got carte blanche, man.
I'm not really sure how safe I feel with you in the room right now.
Why? What did I do? Wait a minute.
That's a general opinion of Brett. I'm not going to lie.
One time you show up somewhere in a Ric Flair robe and all of a sudden you're unpredictable.
You've been eyeballing me since you walked in.
He walks to Kogo's in the Ric Flair robe.
That is true. I'm just like, hey, you know, going to get the newspaper, you know. Yeah, kids, newspapers are still a thing, by the way. But, yeah, so what?
But Brett's here. Scott's here.
Yeah.
It's the Todd DeFazio Show. We're 100% live today. Of course, this episode will air on Monday. But you can catch it right now live on TuneIn Radio, Apple Music, the stream, live online radio, our free Idiot Radio app that you can get in the Apple App Store and in Google Play. I had to change that because I was using iTunes, and they don't apparently use iTunes for anything anymore. I know for those Apple guys, Brett still has a flip phone, and I know Scott's an Android guy like Android. Myself.
Oh, you can take your phone and actually take a picture of something? You can do that now?
I can.
Is that correct? That's wild. I never heard of that.
I know that's a little new school for you. You're really showing your age now.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, you know, the year 2000 was a tough year, you know. I mean,
we had
craziness going on in the White House. Oh, wait. Is that 2000 or 2019? Regardless.
All right.
Come on now. What do we got? What do we got going on today, man?
So, well, have you filmed any new Trouble in Paradise lately?
Yeah, I did. I was talking about, Trouble in Paradise. It was episode 22, and I basically, you know, I know that we try and reach, you know, all parts of the country, you know, with the podcast that we do right now, but I had to get it out for Pittsburgh sports fans that you don't realize how good you have it in terms of Pittsburgh sports. I was like, you know, so like I just did kind of like a Sam Kinison inspired screaming rant, which is, you know, I thought it was good. It was outside South Hills Village Mall, and I just went on a rant. I'm like, people have no idea.
For those people that don't know what Trouble in Paradise is, it's a YouTube channel, and you just basically go all over town, right?
Yeah, I just go to different parts of town
and scream and yell and –
Yeah.
Talk about what's on your mind.
Sounds like my type of show.
You would love it. I mean, look, I was coming in hot with the first episode back in March. I just had my cameraman, Dirty D, he just said, Brett, Tom Brady, what do you think? And I just eviscerated Tom Brady for 5 minutes. I mean, I was coming in hot, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, as my creative juices kept flowing, I came a little more.
Now it's the hottest program on YouTube.
I'm just saying, I'll know.
What the hell was
that? I was like, what did I do gimmick infringement? I got called out for it? Or
yeah, so Trouble in Paradise, check it out on YouTube.
Absolutely.
Follow it and subscribe. So, I don't know. There's this week was pretty – I always have funny stories about my son Vinny and, you know, my kids and everything. And, you know, my oldest Anthony got his license this week, Scott.
Yeah.
Which is
can't wait to see him on the road. He was trying to drive my car last time.
Scott, talk right into your microphone.
Into the microphone.
Yeah, you gotta talk. These mics, you gotta talk right into them.
I can get real close.
I can go farther away just because I'm naturally loud.
He screams.
Let's get real close to the microphone.
But
make sure everybody can hear me.
Oh, you're like those girls from Saturday Night Live, Delicious Dish. Are they talking to the microphone?
It's delicious. I always have a funny story, like, you know, from my kids, and especially Vinny, the four-year-old maniac. I call him, like, the four-year-old Bert Kreischer. He's completely insane. So we had to go to the doctors the other day, Scott. All the kids had checkups. And
should get me one of those.
The 13-year-old. I took him to the to get his checkup. He had a different doctor, and our 10-year-old daughter and 11-year-old daughter and the little 4-year-old maniac had the same doctor, so they were there. And I get in trouble from the future missus. She said, "Did you not check him before we left? You left the house today?" I said, "No. Why?" Apparently, he didn't have any underwear on.
Nice.
But that was just the icing on the cake.
Going commando.
He also took an orange marker and colored his junk. when asked why, he said to me, he said, "I wanted to play a joke on the doctor, Dad."
That's fantastic. Vinny Chooch is my new hero.
Vinny Chooch.
I love it.
Wow.
For those that don't know about Vinny Chooch, he created a wrestling persona for himself. He calls himself Vinny Chooch. And
I'm supposed to be his hero, but he's my hero for coming up with that.
I would have never thought to do that.
Sweatpants, a dress shirt, glasses, which I haven't seen Vinny Chooch in a while, so maybe he's on to something else. But yeah, that's what
he's already in expanding his horizons, even though he lives in your house.
He's completely out of his mind.
So how did the doctor react to that?
He actually was a foreign guy and really didn't say anything. I don't know if he saw it and didn't acknowledge it, or he just kind of felt around with his hands and didn't. Because, you know, they check for her, especially him. He had a hernia when he was born, so they always check him for hernias. So he might have just been poking around. I don't know.
I'm glad you explained the whole feeling around thing.
This is talking about little kids, and feeling around. I'm not touching this one, for lack of a better term.
It was for medical reasons, jeez. did you guys see this Florida rapper? I think his name is like Four Lil Leo or something.
Four
like.
Lil Leo?
Yeah.
What?
That's his
you
name.
Gotta you gotta give you gotta give me some more info on this one.
Well, he filmed his rap video inside of the police station in South Florida without anybody even knowing. He just walked around and filmed this video.
That makes me question some police there. There's no one in the police station.
Yeah, how did he get in there with his phone still intact? Because in times that I was in, you know, in jail, that they take everything.
Wait, what?
What?
Did you say the times that you were in jail?
Yeah. Oh, drunk in public. Okay. Attempted arson. Ooh.
I feel like everyone's done attempted arson at some point.
I mean, come on, okay. You know.
I've seen videos of this guy in fireworks. I mean, that's
I've never been arrested.
Yeah, but you were trying to set yourself on fire.
I don't know. No, I wasn't doing that. It was all for entertainment. But here's Lil the rapper. That's him there at the police station. Those watching on the Facebook and the Facebook Live feed, you can see what Lil looks like. And he's currently selling his song on Amazon for 99 cents. And you can buy it.
Well, this sounds like just good pub to me, man.
Yeah, I mean, I think
you know, like, think about it. I mean, like, oh, by the way, hey, look at me. I've got a new, you know, I was filming the music video that I'm about to release on iTunes, and now I'm getting in trouble, and it's in the media.
Yeah, it's a single. It's called Bust. You want to hear a little sample of it?
Let's see what this guy's got.
It's censored, so, like, it sounds like it's skipping, but it's just censored. I think every time he drops the N-word, it's censored.
Okay.
It's probably I don't the best. Know, so... I think the most creative part of that song was the video.
I couldn't understand a word that was said at all. I mean, like
too much of the same word.
So that's what. Yeah, he gets the buzzer for that because that was.
If you
stupid. You stupid.
Was that scene in Wayne's World when Garth goes to order?
You know
order
you're showing from, your age by these
I don't
references.
Care. Dude, I don't care. Who do you think we're reaching out to right now? Okay.
I don't know, but.
But what I'm saying is it's like going to, it's like, it sounded like going
30
to.
Has no idea what you're talking about.
It's like, okay, it's like going to a drive-thru.
Scott's lost right now.
Okay.
How old are you, Scott?
27.
He's lost. What's Wayne's World? He doesn't know.
I actually do know what that one is. You know.
So what are you saying? I'm sorry.
No, just go into a drive-thru and just go. The song sounds like I'm going to with your – it.
Well, that's because I think World Star censored it or you know, somebody on YouTube censored it. But there is a real like the uncensored version is out.
I don't think that's appropriate for anything.
But that's like if you just – you have nothing – if you have nothing creative to say, you're just either going to curse – or say or do something along those lines. Like if you have nothing creative to say as a rapper, let's throw an N-bomb in there. You know, like at least be a little creative.
I know, it'd be like Wayne and Garth, be like party on, Scott.
Come on, man, help me out. You were just graduating high school, so I didn't want to hear
I'm
it,
old,
pal.
But I'm trying not to show it on the show.
Oh yeah, but yeah.
I'm breaking your beans.
I know.
But here's a good one.
Breaking my beans.
This is going to cause me to break the diet, which I was deathly ill for like 5 days. I had a stomach virus.
Ooh.
And I got over it. So like now I'm like finally starting to like eat normal. But it threw my whole diet off, which I was killing. I was like down like 19 pounds. So...
But
I don't
you
know.
Were trying to lose weight, though.
The goal was to lose 100 for the wedding, Scott.
Yeah, I remember you telling me about that. I'm trying to get involved in your workouts.
In less than a month, it's been a little over a month now. I was down 19 pounds, but it threw all my rhythm off because now I'm eating bad. I just started eating regular food, so I don't know.
You need to stop losing weight because any weight you lose, I seem to be finding.
That's all right. I'll keep giving it to you. But we may have to have a cheat day here very, very soon, Brett. This is amazing. It's being tested here in Pittsburgh. KFC is testing a fried chicken and glazed sandwich.
Oh.
Glazed donut sandwich.
I did see. Okay.
In our Pittsburgh area restaurants. And I've already seen a few people get them. And that looks amazing. You can see it on the Facebook Lives. So if
wrong with that.
You can watch it live and see it, and you know you can be part of the show. 412-407 shows the number.
See, I remember when KFC came out. Now, I mean, the donut thing is just that. That's a whole another level of
they're innovative. I think they have a bunch of potheads over there.
Is it innovative?
Because remember when they came out with the chicken bowls. It had the mashed potatoes,
the gravy,
the corn,
yeah,
the cheese, the
crashed
potatoes, the gravy, the corn, the cheese, and cut up pieces of the original recipe all in one bowl. That is a 420 person,
but I think
right
that,
there.
I was just gonna say I think that that's what they got in there right now because recently they came out with a sandwich with Cheetos on it, Anything that people most likely do when they're high.
And they all sound delicious. They're developmental. I mean, not that I participate, but
at KFC.
I just want the sandwich. I'm all for that sandwich right now.
I think we need to leave the show when we're done and go get a KFC road trip.
But
do you remember when they're kind of innovators, though, because if you remember a couple years ago, they had the Double Down sandwich, which it was two boneless, skinless. Or no, it wasn't skinless, but it was two chicken breasts. It was the original recipe chicken breasts with a piece of ham and cheese on it and like some sort of like boom boom sauce or something. But it was just two
the original bun was the pieces of chicken. This segment has been brought to you by KFC. The Colonel knows best.
Fantastic.
11 herbs and spices. Thank you. No.
Is it 11?
This segment
I don't know.
Is making me hungry.
Right.
I know. Now we got to take a time out and go. So it's Monday. It's Wednesday, but this show will air Monday. And
you know what?
I said silence to phones before the show. Brett's phone's going off.
I can't help it.
When you're coming on Monday and you're not feeling real well, does anyone ever say to you, sounds like someone has a case of the Mondays? No, man.
Yeah, today's Monday.
No, Saturday.
Or Wednesday, because we're live.
No, today's Monday.
No, Saturday.
No, I'm sorry. Today's Monday.
What day is it? Monday? Oh, Monday. Thank God it's Monday.
You're the only moron in the whole world who actually likes Monday.
Have a super awesome day of positivity.
Ugh, it's Monday. Well, it's Wednesday if you're listening live on our group, our Facebook group. So we appreciate everybody listening. Any feedback in the comments or on the, you know, calling into the show and leaving a message. You can also text that, too. If you don't want to call in and you're a little bit shy, you just text 412-407-SHOW and be a part of what we're talking about.
You want to do that.
Yeah.
You absolutely want to do that.
Be the fourth mic person today.
Please do, because I'm really already tired of talking to these two. So please,
wow.
Somebody call, please.
Thanks. Coming in hot is Scott.
Thank you.
Catch up on the podcast from all our shows like the Triple B Experience anytime, anywhere, from any computer or mobile device, the Apple Podcast, Google Play, SoundCloud, Spreaker, YouTube, Spotify, iHeartRadio, and now every Monday we are on Facebook Live. Check us out for the premiere of this episode. And now we're trying it out. When we record, we're live because I miss the phone calls. I miss hearing from some of the old friends of the shows from yesteryear. So, if you're out there, call, please. I miss you guys, and I want to talk to you guys. Brett, we got a great show planned today. We're going to talk about lots of great stuff. Today, a brand new Who's Who's list. We're going to have that. It's movie-related because Hannah's not here. And I don't really want to talk about guys.
I was just about to jump in and say, please, that's the only bonus about Hannah not being here because, you know, it would always be about top five, like, cutest guys or hottest guys or hottest guys in movies.
I can take that place if you'd like. I will name the top five.
Okay.
No.
Top five, all Ryan Reynolds right there.
Mark Wahlberg, sir.
No. Mark Ryan Wahlberg. Reynolds, top five.
What's trending in TV and movies, plus the top songs of the weeks. And our show topic this week is what's the craziest drunk purchases you have ever made? I think I was just saying on the internet, and Brett kind of left it open, but Yin's responded, so we're gonna talk about that. And Scott, I'm sure you have a story like that, drunk purchases.
I can give you just about drunk anything at this point.
Okay,
I'm 27. I'm drunk 90% of the time.
We're gonna talk about all that and a whole bunch more. It's the Todd DeFazio show. We're gonna take our first break right here on Idiot Radio, and we'll be back right after this.
For all your heating and cooling needs, service, and installation, contact our friends at Complete Comfort Heating and Air Conditioning, 412-513-3001. Doesn't your family deserve complete comfort?
We're back on the Todd DeFazio Show with Brett. And Hannah, but it's actually Scott today.
You can call me Hannah if that makes you feel better.
Well, she's much better looking than you. No offense, guy.
I'll argue that one a little bit. Just I don't think I'm the worst looking guy in the world.
Yeah,
I also don't think I'm the worst looking girl either.
You're very handsome. You're a very handsome fella. But you know,
Hannah's a solid nine and a half.
Hannah has a lot of fans of the show. Now we had what, a 15-second break, Scott?
Yeah, 15 seconds. Is that what it was?
Yeah, about that. It was a commercial. And we come back, and Brett has completely changed his clothes. Now
bingo!
He has a two. For those on Facebook can see it. Those that cannot are listening on the podcast or on the app. He's wearing Jerome Bettis throwback.
Throwback. It's the old school, too.
And it's
with the
two-tone. Watch the wires. You're pulling wires. The two-tone Jerome Bettis, half black, half white.
Best of both worlds.
Yeah.
I'm a uniter.
I should say half home, half away. How about that?
I'm not sure how many layers he's wearing, so I'm not sure what I'm going to get to see today.
Well, we'll see. We'll see how long the show goes. You know, I mean, I got a couple, but I don't know how many layers I have. All right. I'm just saying. At least we're not playing. If we were playing strip poker, I got some house money. I can honestly say
I will never play strip poker with you. Scott, on the other hand.
Probably. You're in love. There's a little chemistry going on. We have a little man thing going on. Not that there's anything.
I wouldn't call it a little man thing.
Well.
Jesus, Garrison.
Keep it going. And you guys are Bert Kreischer fans. I love Bert Kreischer. I'm a huge Bert Kreischer fan.
He's all right, I guess.
You're not a big Bert Kreischer fan?
I mean, he's got good hair. That's about all I know.
Scott, you like Bert?
No idea who he is.
Oh, he's a comedian.
Not a clue.
Okay. I'm thinking
he's a comedian, and he's well known for. One of the biggest things he was known for is, you know, the movie Van Wilder that Ryan Reynolds played in.
Obviously, I know that one.
The character Van Wilder is based on Bert Kreischer.
Oh, learn something every day.
It's Bert Kreischer that. Is Van Wilder.
Yeah.
He's very well known for this bit he does in a stand-up act. It's like, you know how, like, every big star has their, or, like, musician has their, like, they call it the Freebird. It's, like, their big song or whatever. Bert has a story where he calls it, he calls himself the Machine in Russia.
Yeah, okay.
And the Machine, here, I'll play the clip of it, of the Machine.
It doesn't matter, because the second the door opens and I'm face to face with a real Russian gangster with the wife beater and the tattoos with the track pants and the cigarette, and he just stares me up and down. A frat boy from Florida State. I was wearing a fanny pack. He just looks at me and goes, "Stole." I fucking panicked. And everything I had planned on saying flooded out of my head. And all I said to him in Russian in his doorway was, "I am the Machine." And he started laughing. He goes, "What did you say?" I was like, "I'm the Machine." He grabs me and he goes, "Come in and tell my friends." Brings me in a room full of 9 Russian gangsters drinking and smoking and just goes, "Stop. Tell them what you said." Now I'm like, "Fuck it. I'm the Machine." They looked at each other, looked at me, and they're like, "Fuck it. He's the Machine."
So, yeah, the Bert, that premise, that bit that's made Bert Kreischer so famous. I probably should have put a warning on there about the curse words, but too late now. I forgot to censor it. Our censorship department was a little off.
Before you go any further, I just gotta stop for 1 second and tell you, when you said Bert Kreischer, now I know who it is, the Machine guy. That's how I know him. But I thought you meant the press secretary Jared Kushner, not Bert Kreischer. I swear I could. I know. I feel so terrible.
Yeah, because we do politics on the show.
I know. That's what I mean. I don't know where it came from. I just got done watching C-SPAN before I got here. What do you want me to do?
That was a good show prep.
Well, I don't know what you're going to come up with. You surprise me every time.
I got to use two sound effects. That's
Bert Kreischer, though. Yeah, no, the Machine thing is classic.
But he's cashing in on the Machine now. He's It's going to be made into a movie by Legendary Films. And my big question is, who's going to play Bert?
Jonah Hill.
They're too old, because you got to figure college age. Somebody college age. Like, I don't know. I would Zac Efron, but he's too old now, I think.
I just said Jonah Hill because in Bert's act, he does it without a shirt on, and he's kind of flubbery.
Yeah, but that's jibbery. Dad bod Bert. That was before his. That's now he's a dad and everything. So
he got bigger or just?
Yeah, he was like the king of his campus. He was there like 7 years, and that's where all the stories for his stuff comes from.
No, the one that I saw, he does it without his shirt on, and he's flubbery.
Now.
I'm like, that's why I, off the top of my head, I would have said Jonah Hill right away. You know,
I think Brad Paradise should play Bert Kreischer for the Machine movie.
I don't know if he's flubbery enough for that.
I am.
Well, it's when Bert's in college, so you know he's thinner.
So he's just flubbery enough.
Yeah.
I did get kind of cut up after I came out of the hospital for my stroke and stuff. So like, I mean, I could pull it off, I guess.
I suppose.
You know, I can talk with a fake Russian accent.
Have somebody that you want to that you think would be great to play the Bert Kreischer character in the Machine movie, give us a call, 412-407-SHOW, or text us, 412-407-SHOW, on or any timeline or in the comments there of the live feed.
Seth Green.
Who's Seth?
Seth Green, redhead, Dr. Evil's kid.
Oh, I don't know, maybe.
Maybe? I'm just...
What do you say, Scott?
It took me a second to realize who he was talking about.
Yeah.
But that might be a good fit. Although I don't think I'd see him anything other than
I think
Dr.
Brett's
Evil
stuck
son.
In the 90s. So Brett's everything mid-90s.
Yeah, so I was three.
He has a pager.
Maybe I do. Maybe I do. And it's, yeah, look, I'm just saying, I'm throwing out names off the top of my head. What do you want me to say? John Cena? You want to go down the wrestling route?
No.
Then there you go.
I don't want to see John Cena play Bert Kreischer. I would maybe punch the TV.
Well,
that's a waste of a perfectly good TV.
Let's see. Did you guys see this week that, or this past week, the Tennessee Titans did a tribute to their former quarterback that passed away, Steve McNair. Mm-hmm. They retired his number 9 jersey.
No, that's good, though. I mean, that's cool.
Yeah, they did, like, a retirement ceremony. What's crazy is the number – there was a cloud. People have pictures of a cloud shaped like the number 9 in the crowd. Those of you on Facebook can see it, but I can describe it. It's just a cloud in the sky, and it looks like the number 9.
That's a very, very good description.
See,
I don't know how much more detail you need to be.
You could – the blue sky and
the sky
nice
was
little
blue,
number 9 there.
And the Titans still
it's got a nice
suck.
It's got a nice little scoop at the end of the 9 there.
Yeah.
Hey, but, come on. You know that's doctored. There ain't no way that's doctored. And let me tell you something about 2002 in that playoff game against the Steelers. Dwayne Washington, that wasn't kicker interference in that.
Okay.
Deal with that. That's what some Yinzer would say right now. Right now, somebody from Pittsburgh, love my Pittsburgh. Somebody right now is going, oh, that McNair, he should have lost that game back in 2002. Like, they don't forget. They don't forget. They're hardcore. So, but like, regardless, I mean, that's nice that they honored McNair.
Yeah, well, they retired his jersey and everything.
You know, he passed away under, you know, nefarious manners. None of his business.
That's a big
what
word
he did
for you, Brett.
Well, yeah.
Scott's looking it up on Google right now.
Only how to spell it.
So, we don't really go to Pittsburgh because, like I said, we're all over the place, worldwide. There's a Pittsburgh story today. Well, kind of a Pittsburgh story today. There's a lot of stuff going on with former Steelers wide receiver Antonio Brown. A lot of negative stuff that I don't really want to talk about.
Was there anything positive ever?
Like bad stuff, and I don't want to talk about that. But the reason that Jabron made the show is a Pittsburgh area doctor filed a lawsuit this week against the former Steeler wide receiver. He's a Monroeville doctor, Monroeville, Victor Prisk. We should try to get Victor Prisk on the show. Do you think we could get Victor Prisk on the show?
I think you could do anything.
I'm sure it's attainable. He's local. So,
it's possible, I suppose. I mean, we're one of the top broadcasts.
We could just call his office and be like, we'll just send Brett there and do an right there on the spot interview with him.
Wait a minute. I'm going to need a little fuel for this. What kind of doctor is he?
It doesn't say what he is, but old Dr. Prisk filed a lawsuit in Pennsylvania claiming that Brown owes him $11,500 in unpaid fees.
Unpaid fees?
You would think the NFL has a better insurance plan than that for all his co-pays that he blew up. So he's suing him for that, but there's more to the story, and that's why it made the show. Not only that, the New York Post is claiming that Brown reportedly farted in the face of the doctor during his consultations, and he would always show up 3 hours late.
I was wondering what the dramatic pause was for. Because I was like, it was that anticipation. You know, like, it was like he farted in his face?
Yeah, now I really want to know what kind of doctor this was.
Was it
that someone's farting in his face?
Was it wet, dry? What did he have before? Was he eating Chipotle? You know, like
it was repeatedly, so he was doing it all the time to him. So yeah, I guess. Brown.
That's only like the 15th weirdest or worst thing that's happened to Antonio Brown in the past 2 weeks.
Yeah, doesn't even break the top five of the weirdest things you've ever done.
Oh my God, that's top 20. Come on.
He did weirder on the way here.
I was gonna say, you should have saw me passing people on the road by the giant that unnamed grocery store. Oh yeah, yeah. That's that. I mean, look, Antonio Brown. Has it come to this with Antonio Brown that we're worried about him, you know, dropping his trousers and pooing in a doctor's face?
I don't know.
I honestly think that'd be a good story.
I had the wrong button.
I was like, wait a minute. Was that bad of a joke?
No.
I'm coming with the best I got.
I hit the wrong button on that. That was my fault.
Look, anybody, any Steeler fan, you know, or any fan of any team that he's on, you've got to realize that the bottom line is that at the end of the day, all of these guys are you cheer the shield, not the name on the back. So for the couple years that Antonio Brown gave us, I got no problem.
Hall
of Famer.
I don't really want to get too Antonio Brown and too sports because there's a lot of people that don't like sports. But there's definitely something wrong. Like, he's on something. He needs an intervention. Like Scott gave me a time when I was eating too much at the buffet, and he was like, we need to sit down, buddy.
And then we'll eat the food we got from the buffet.
But, I mean, nonetheless.
What, did he hand you a salad instead of the ribs or something?
Nonetheless, Antonio Brown dropping bunnies in a doctor's face repeatedly is funny to me.
Yeah, there were farts everywhere and toots. It's crazy.
Now, did you guys hear about this kid from the University of Tennessee? What's going on with this kid? This Tennessee kid got made fun of at his school because it was college day and everybody got to wear their favorite college team, and he didn't have one. His family couldn't afford it, so he made a University of Tennessee T-shirt for college. Did you see this, Scott?
I did not.
Here's the T-shirt for those on Facebook. They can see it. He kind of just made it with a piece of paper and scribbled UT on the paper. And this turned out to be something pretty big for this kid. He got bullied and made fun of by all the kids in school, and it kind of went viral, the story. And the University of Tennessee made it their official T-shirt for this season, and the entire band was wearing it this past week. And so far they have sold over 16,000 T-shirts. And to top it all off, they're giving the kid a 4-year scholarship to Tennessee.
See, that's just a good story right there.
Yeah, see, that's what we're about. The power of positivity. That's what the Todd DeFazio show is all about.
Whoa.
Farts and doctors' faces and positivity. And Brett using big words.
Feel the power. Oh, come on, nefarious. I can come up with some more. Verisimilitude. Well, I don't know. I'll keep going with it.
Okay. So it's now time for our favorite part of the show, but she's not here. It's the...
substitute teacher.
It's the Who's Who's List with Hannah, brought to you by Rich Who Entertainment. Well, Hannah's not here. It's me, Todd. And it's brought to you by our friends at Rich Who Entertainment, DJs for all occasions. Give Rich and his staff a call for a free estimate and a tailor-made package to fit all your entertainment needs. 412-266-1266. Tell him that Brett Paradise sent you.
Absolutely.
And he's a big fan. Today's list, it's usually like a countdown or a top five list or something. Today's list is... the top upcoming movies, in no particular order, that people are most excited about. The top upcoming movies that people are most excited about. Some of them, some people know. I didn't know about some of them. So the biggest one I'm excited about is Won't You Be My Neighbor, the Mr. Rogers movie with Tom Hanks.
Now, let me tell you, let me say something about that. We were talking about movies. Remember a couple weeks ago when we did movies that made you cry?
Yeah.
Guaranteed that's on the list.
You know what?
Guaranteed.
Did you see, do you know Mr. Are you, Scott, are you too young for Mr. Rogers?
No, I know of him. I didn't get a chance to watch a lot, though.
You didn't watch, you're a Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood kind of guy, right?
I'm a what?
Well, now they have a cartoon called Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood.
I have no idea what that is.
It's a...
I don't either.
It's Mr. Rogers, but with a cartoon tiger.
Yeah, that's
a little
that
puppet.
That just doesn't seem right.
So when I saw this, I had, like, chills on my arms because it was like, you know, like the hairs on my arm were standing up because of how... There were times he looks like Tom Hanks, but there are times that he was, like, spot on, like Mr. Rogers. Did you see the trailer for Spread?
Yes.
I think we talked about this a few weeks ago. Another movie that people are most excited for that's coming up, Top Gun Maverick, the Top Gun sequel.
Hmm.
Everybody's excited about that.
I think it's too late.
I think it's a few years too late. Even though Tom Cruise looks exactly the same.
Because he doesn't age.
They have a different female.
He's a wizard.
They have a different female lead for
Crazy
that.
Crazy don't crack.
Female lead in the original was Kelly McGillis.
Yeah.
And now she looks like an old grandma that plays bingo. So she wasn't even asked to be in the movie.
Oh.
She was like, they didn't even ask me to be in the movie.
Yeah, she looked like she was in Steel Magnolias. If they were remaking that, she could be a shoe-in for that, maybe.
And she was smoking hot, Scott, in the
smoking
original.
Smoking hot.
I have actually seen Top Gun.
So,
like, I have
yeah,
seen
remember
it.
The chick from that?
Yeah,
I used to watch it on the VHS all the time.
Yeah, there you go.
She was hot, though.
I do remember the check. I do. Yeah, no, she's pretty
hot. She is not anymore.
I don't know what she looks like now. I wish you would have pulled up a picture of her.
I didn't even think of it till just now.
She officially jumped the
shark. That's why we need a producer. So anybody looking for a producer job, 412-407-SHOW, come be part of the show with us.
Anyone looking for a date as well. I'm
single
and ready to mingle, so...
Giggity
it out
single.
There.
All right.
We'll have to do Scott's date. We'll do a Scott dating game or something.
Oh my!
Let's not get into the dating.
No, we can help. Yeah, we can help.
That
this is like this is like yeah this is like Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Another big movie coming out: Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters 3. I know they're getting close to starting to film, and left and right, people are confirming that they are part of the movie. So
is that with the same cast from the second one?
The original one and two, the original Ghostbusters, except for Ramis because he passed away, right?
Right. Yeah. No. It's still Ernie Hudson and
McElroy,
Dan Aykroyd
Bill
and
Murray.
Bill Murray.
Yeah. And
Rick Moranis. You got to have Rick Moranis in it. Sigourney
Weaver.
I hope
Rick Moranis is in it because he's...
Vince Clortho, Keymaster of Gozer.
He's not done anything in a long time Hollywood-wise.
No, he actually... One of the things that with Rick Moranis is he quit acting.
Yeah.
Like, he moved back up to Canada because he's originally from Canada.
Hey.
Hey. Yes, I know. Yeah.
But yeah, no, he...
French-Canadian.
He's not confirmed. I read somewhere that... Sigourney Weaver, maybe?
Yes.
Is going to be part of it. I hope so. Nonetheless, I'm going to be excited for it. Another movie that people are excited for, this is the Who's Who's List brought to you by Rich Entertainment right here on the Todd DeFazio Show. The Rise of Skywalker comes out in December.
Huh.
The third installment of the third trilogy.
Now, there's one I'd like to see who plays Skywalker. You know, like, well, who is going to be
Mark Hamill as Skywalker?
No, but I mean, if they're going to, if it's the rise of, that means they got to have a young Luke.
I'm trying to stay away from.
They can do whatever they want. That's the best part.
Yeah, I'm trying because they've ignored whenever. The books that took place after Return of the Jedi. They've completely ignored them. So,
wait, there are books?
Yeah, there's a series of books that have nothing. Like, they just said, okay, there was, like, a family tree and everything.
That's
and
like saying Harry Potter has books. That just doesn't make sense.
But I don't think the books were Lucas endorsed, if that makes any sense. So, like, the stories continued, and they, like, there's kids and all this and that. And even Marvel had comics has at one time. I don't know if they still do, but they had Star Wars comics.
So, I don't understand any of these people.
This is where my nerd side.
You're showing it off big time.
All you had to do was talk about books, and I was just gone.
Yeah, it sounded like the teacher.
Here's
in
another upcoming movie that people are very excited about: The $6 Billion Man, and that's starring that Mark Wahlberg.
Uh-huh.
Oh, your favorite. Oh, you'd hit that.
Oh man,
he's really ripped
Wait,
up right
it's,
now.
They moved it up to 6 billion.
Yeah, they had
you talk about inflation.
Well, a $6 million man nowadays, you're just getting a cast on your leg.
Yeah, you're paying off your student loans and buying a car, and that's about it.
It's a used car, by the way.
Yeah,
another one, you're buying a Saturn.
Another
one everybody's excited about, the Black Widow.
That one I am actually excited about.
Does that have to do with spiders?
It is a prequel to the Avengers, I guess.
I believe so. It's
this is what you
the Black
would
Widow's origin story.
Yeah, it's an origin. That's Scott. See, you knew it.
See, I'm useful sometimes.
It's an origin story for the Black
often.
Widow. Coming to America 2. A lot of the people from the original are confirmed.
Should probably see the first one.
You haven't
You've
seen
never,
the first
Scott,
one?
Scott, you got homework before you come back.
Oh, my Lord. Absolutely. Please.
You got to watch that movie before you come back. Or you're not allowed back.
Joe Louis, the greatest boxer ever lived. He batted Cash Clay. He batted Sugar Ray. He batted Hoodoo Noodle Boy. Mike Tyson looked like a bulldog him. He done whip his ass. He whip all the ass. You have never seen that?
I've never seen that. I mean, I've seen that.
Eddie Murphy, he nailed that. That was a very good. When you come back, you can say, "Wow, that you sound just like it." It was an Eddie Murphy was like four or five different characters.
Wait a second. If the man wants to change his name to Muhammad Ali, by God, you respect his wishes. You change his name to Muhammad Ali, and I'ma call him Clay. I'ma call him Clay. That's what you. I can't believe
he
has a mic shot. The barbershop scene.
He reenacted the entire barbershop scene.
He ain't lying.
I guess I have homework, so I got nothing going on later. So maybe watch it.
It's an American classic. It's one of my top three all favorites. Coming to America.
I mean, if you want me to keep going, I'll do it.
No, we're moving on. Cruella's coming out next year, I believe. Cruella De Vil.
Are they bringing back
live action movie?
Yeah,
are they bringing back Glenn Close to play? Because she did the 101 Dalmatian live action.
I don't think so.
Live action movies are ruined for me.
Yeah, I mean the Disney live action—they're just like pumping. I think Mulan is even set to come out. Like they're just pumping them out one after another.
I can tell you why too. Aladdin.
Why?
Aladdin.
Aladdin was really bad.
Aladdin ruined them all for me.
It because of Aladdin. I won't watch Aladdin.
No, Aladdin is ruined. I got halfway through it and shut it off because I kept trying to sing along from my childhood.
But it
was
different.
And they changed the words.
Did they? I
was visibly upset.
What was your opinion of the Will Smith genie?
Oh, don't even get me started on that one. That was just horrible.
It's not
the worst.
It's funny.
We're talking about Will Smith.
We're going right into Bad Boys for Life. I believe they're almost done filming it right now. And Brett's raising his hand. What are you?
No.
Did he call on you? I don't think he called on you yet.
No. I talk a lot like that because I wave my hands.
He's
around
very
a lot.
Excited, as you can see, Scott. Scott's
one
like
of the things
in
that
the corner. He keeps moving further away.
Because he thinks I'm about to smack him, and I swear I'm not going to.
I told you he was eyeballing me.
No, I'm not eyeballing you.
You're eyeballing me.
Look, with the Bad Boys thing, one of the things that I like about the Bad Boys movies is there, as far as the stunts and car crashes, this is actual from the director. None of it's CGI'd. All of it is all of the car crashes and everything that you see in the Bad Boys movies, that's all like live actual car. So if a car gets hit or a car gets flipped over on the on the highway or on the expressway, whatever, that actually happened. There's no CGI in those things. So that's one of the reasons why I love the Bad Boys movies and I can't get enough of them, because even the Fast and the Furious has gone CG.
It's funny you say that.
That's because they're running out of stunts.
I know they've went to. Did they go to space yet? Almost.
Maybe. No, they're working their way to space.
Fast and Furious 9 is another one that everybody's excited about.
What?
They can go up to 50. People will keep going to watch.
The original ones were awesome, and I liked how they kind of went out of order. And then the one movie, I think it was 6, puts everything together. Like Tokyo Drift.
Yeah, I was confused when I first
movies.
Saw Tokyo Drift.
Yeah,
and then they just brought
it
all
back
together.
It was like so random that movie came out. But I'm excited for that. Another one is Birds of Prey. Margot Robbie will be reprising her role as Harley Quinn. And Birds of Prey is all the DC female like superheroes that are like girls.
Hopefully DC can make a good movie then.
Batgirl becomes, she's in a wheelchair because she was injured, and she becomes Oracle. And
see, if you guys want to get into the DC Marvel stuff, I know a bunch of people, including myself, that we could talk about that one. That can be a topic for another day. That can be something new
be
that you know nothing
if
about.
If they have the money, they can come through the podcast here. Bond 25, Daniel Craig's last run as James Bond.
It's called 25? That's
Bond
the name of the
25, yeah.
Come on. They used to come up with such cool names. Tomorrow Never Dies.
I'm
Dr.
Sure
no.
There might
Goldfinger.
Be, there
Skyfall.
Might be, there might be a subtitle in there somewhere.
I mean,
Wonder Woman 1984 is the sequel to the Wonder Woman movie. They seem to be dumping the characters from, already recast Batman. Robert Pattinson's going to play him from them. The Twilight guy, which I'm not a fan of.
Wait.
I don't see.
The Twilight guy is but now Batman. So you didn't know that, Scott?
What?
Yeah. True story.
I'm a big fan of the superhero movies, and that just ruined Batman.
Yeah. Well, if they give him some Diana Ball or something, maybe. Oh, you know.
He would be a better Joker, I think, than Batman. I said that before.
Yeah, you did.
The movie's gonna be a joke.
Superman's getting recast. Superman's getting recasted. It seems like Marvel nails the movies, and DC nails it on the TV side. Their TV franchise is bigger than their.
That's because they tried to make Batman versus Superman, and that ruined.
See, I didn't
it
hate
everyone.
Batman versus Superman. I hated.
What you did? What you like that one?
I didn't hate it. I did.
Let's be best friends. Both of our moms' names are Martha.
Only thing I hated about it is Superman was significantly smaller than Batman.
That's because you had to
Batman is so much or Superman is so much bigger than in the comics than Batman. If there were girls listening to the show, there is not now.
Yeah, another guy.
Well,
now.
ladies, listen. I'm looking at you in the camera right now. Listen,
Look
they
away.
Can talk about the comic books all they want. Listen, I don't read comic books.
He doesn't
partially
read.
Because I can't read.
There it is.
But that's not the point. See? So if it unless it has like Bruce Willis saying something cool and then something blowing up, I don't know what's going on.
I'm pretty sure Bruce Willis is in some superhero movies.
Huh?
Bruce Willis is probably in
He's
some
in G.I. Joe, I know that.
Nice. He's got to be playing Flint. No, see, G.I. Joe, I can get behind
it. He just calls himself Joe, I think, in the movie. Avatar 2 is the last one on our list. That was a really long who's list, but thank you to all our friends at Rich Hugh Entertainment, DJs for All Occasions, for sponsoring that. 412-266-1266. Give them a call, and we're ready for a break, I think. Brett, you ready for a break? Probably.
Yeah.
You have an outfit ready?
I think
you
I got something
got an
going
outfit
on.
Over here?
I got something over here in the garage.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. It's the Todd DeFazio Show with Brett and Scott. Hannah's on vacation. Scott, thanks for filling in. We'll be back right after this.
Looking for a DJ for your next party, corporate event, wedding, or special occasion? Contact Rich Hu Entertainment, the official DJ of Idiot Radio. For free quote and information, give them a call at 412-266-1266. That's 412-266-1266. Rich Hu Entertainment, DJs for all occasions.
We're back, and just like that, Scott, you need to take a look over at...
Oh, God.
He has now changed clothes.
He literally changed without me seeing him, again. And we're in the same room.
Mm. I'm slick like that.
He just slides right
just
in.
A little bit.
Watch out, ladies. Just slides right in.
I think we need a clothing company to sponsor Brett's outfit change.
Absolutely.
So we know anybody that has a clothing company, please... feel free to sponsor Brett's clothing changes.
Or maybe hair products. I could use those. That'd be fantastic. It'd be
He's
wonderful.
A lot of breath.
Well, hey, you
gotta... works fast, man.
Yeah. I'm trying to carve up. I know that we don't get... This is live right now on Facebook, but this won't go on idiotradio.net till Monday.
I heard that somewhere.
Yeah, no. And
well, time.
Story.
I got a lot of energy, and I got to carb up before the Dormont Dash on Monday because I'm running the net.
You're running the Dormont Dash.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Are you wearing an Idiot Radio T-shirt? Are you gonna change outfits every so many feet?
Every half mile. I'm gonna change my shirt. I'll have my Brett 419
Please run
shirt
it.
On.
Please run it in your robe. Please.
You should start in the robe.
You should run the whole race in the robe.
I might do that, or I might just bring my heavyweight championship belt with me.
You're just going to run it in the belt?
I'm just going to declare myself the winner ahead of time.
The belt and tidy whities.
I think that sounds like a fantastic look. I think it's going to be huge. I'm telling you, I might just
I don't
do
think
something
it's
going like to
be
that.
Huge. I think it's supposed to be cold that day.
Scott, he takes that belt everywhere he goes.
You got to be proud of something.
Like, he's that loose moose.
The loose moose. I've been there once.
Oh, yeah. Loose moose. I'm like, these are fantastic wings. This is wonderful. Oh, by the way, look at this. I just buffed it out, too.
Does that pickup line work
wonderful.
For you?
Wonderful. What?
Does that pickup line work for you?
Which voice?
No, the line with the belt, not the actual voice.
Oh, I don't know.
I can see the voices working. That's the best threesome ever, but the belt, the belt itself.
Oh, absolutely. You get heads turning anywhere. Last Saturday, I was at Wahlburgers. We were talking about Mark Wahlberg, right?
Yeah, your man Candy Monday.
What's that?
Your man Candy Monday.
Yeah, man Candy Monday, man crush Monday. I'd prefer
whatever
man crush Monday because that sounds dirty.
I like
candy
for you.
That you like
seems
candy?
That seems like a good fit for you. Your man Candy Monday.
My sister's name's Candace, and she sometimes goes by Candy. So, yeah, that just doesn't work for me. That's weird.
That makes it more fun for me.
It makes fun for you. Gross for me.
If I'm having a good time, that's all that matters.
Well, then it's all
well.
That matters.
Anybody who is at the Brookline or the Brookline Breeze, the Dormont Dash,
Dash,
and you can send Brookline pictures Breeze, of us.
Brett 419, brother.
Brett running in
getting
the race.
Getting it done.
idiotradionet@gmail.com. Send them to us, please. Or just send them to us on our social.
Oh, you want it.
Or take them and tag us. Whatever you can do, it will be appreciated. We'll send you out some swag if you can deliver.
I'll personally give you a Brett 419 Brett Paradise t-shirt.
Oh, man.
Just happened.
That's better than dinner at Denny's.
Dinner at Denny's, and you can get cheese on your burger. Believe it.
That sounds like a great first date to me.
So did you guys hear about
the... mind if I steal that date idea there?
Yeah.
The American Airlines Arena in Miami is going to change names here. It's also known as the AAA. And it's the home of the Miami Heat since its construction in 1999. But recently, American Airlines said last year that they no longer want to partake in the naming rights of this and sponsor the venue. So a bidding war has gone underway for the American Airlines Arena, and one of the highest bidders for the arena is a little company that goes by the name of Bang Brothers.
I've never heard of that one. Can you tell me what it is?
It is an adult film company.
Adult film company.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to take it. I got to pull away from the microphone.
So they've bid $10 million for a 10-year naming right contract. The AAA, the American Airlines Arena... could be the Bang Bros Center.
The Bang Bros.
I can't.
Do the Bang Bros have a website I should visit to learn more about them?
If you are under 18, I would not recommend. Or at work, not for work.
You mean to tell me?
Depends on what you do.
Okay. Just one thing. You said, is there a website?
Is there a
excellent
website?
Yeah. Yeah. Is there a website that we can check out?
I can look at it. I'm just curious what it is. Sure. I've never heard of it before.
Yeah.
I got this nifty.
I mean, like, you think of something like NBC or ABC or one of the big networks or SportsCenter. All these people, they would have to say, because they have to say, when they're talking about, the old Console Energy Center, they call it the PPG Paints Arena. You know, they don't call it Pittsburgh Steelers Stadium. They call it Heinz Field. So you mean to tell me that instead of saying, we're back here live on SportsCenter at the Bang Bros Arena, like, they have to say that. They would have to say Bang Bros.
The Bang Bros Center.
Bang Bros.
Please,
the Double B Center.
Please tell me that the bathrooms are called like the Brazzers Bukkake or something. Please tell me. What? That wasn't even a curse. I'm just saying.
So, yeah.
So moving on from that one,
the Bang Bros Center in Miami.
It's the two girls, one cup beer pit or something. Like
Heinz.
What? That wasn't even that bad.
You know, Heinz Field is up for naming rights this year.
Speaking of.
How about Idiot Radio Field? That'd be fantastic. I'm going to put a bid. $10. I got $10 in a Snickers.
Paradise Alley.
You did have a Snickers.
You are hungry.
In Rio de Janeiro, a man tries to mug a woman. Unfortunately for him, it is UFC fighter Pollyanna Viana.
She gets
beaten senseless. For those on Facebook, I can show you a picture of what he looks like. There's Pollyanna, and there's the poor goof that tried to rob her.
For those of you that were wondering, people pay good money to have this happen to them.
Yeah, there's probably...
It happens at the Bang Bros Arena.
Yeah, you can probably see it on Bang Bros. It's really tastefully done, though.
Tasteful. That's very tasteful.
That's crazy. That's that guy's luck. She mopped the floor with him. You can see it on the pictures on her live
feed. She looks really nice.
She does seem like a nice girl. Like she like.
Did he thank her after she was done?
Oh, he paid her. He paid her.
I bet he don't even have teeth. He got to get his jaw wired shut. I mean, he looks bad.
You look at a girl like that.
Now, obviously, that's like the glamour shots of UFC fighting 8x10s. But even still, you have to look at a girl like that and think, you know, and see a female, just any female like that, and think, she's pretty in shape.
I'm not
going
to lie to you. I can't tell you how many times I've been at the gym. Like, I'm going to go talk to her. Then I'm like, nope, she can kill me.
Yeah. You never know, though. I mean, she could have, like, a baggy shirt. You can't. I mean, it doesn't, unless she has her UFC uniform on, you're not going to be able to tell. So it's, the women aren't like the guys. You're not.
I mean, it's not like going up to a player in the WNBA, you know, one of the WNBA girls, you know, females, and, you know, you can tell, like, they'll, you know, they're 7 feet tall, you know, or something like that. You know, but, like,
does the WNBA have do they have a basketball team from Miami?
I don't know. I couldn't possibly tell you, but I'm saying, like, you could, like, if you see Brittany Griner or something, I'm thinking of a name off the top of my head that, you know, in the WNBA, you're like,
you had Brittany Griner. I don't even know who that. Why did you just go like Lisa Leslie or something?
Well, Brittany Griner was like the number one.
I'm gonna be honest. I think you're going back to Bang Bros Arena right now with the Brittany Griner name.
I'm busting your chops.
Brittany Griner.
I'm beating up on Brett pretty good today.
You're busting my chops, something fierce, brother.
Now, this is something fierce. A man admits to having drunken sex with a traffic cone in a train station. His name is Trevor Smith. He was 38 years old. Was sitting on the floor of the lift with a cone turned upside down. That's a small hole, Brett.
Yeah.
A small hole.
I got it.
And he was, you know, making love to the cone.
Was he
making
sweet love to the cone.
Sweet love.
Yes, he was.
God, those things are made of hard rubber. I mean, you better lube that up, man.
He was
good,
like,
Lord. And plus, those are usually pretty thick, which means homeboy's packing.
I wonder where, if he just used. It's probably not for the show. if he went completely dry, or
that's what I'm saying. Yeah, and it's that hard rubber stuff too.
Like, how drunk? And what was he drinking? Like, how drunk do you have to be to make love to a traffic cone?
About half a White Claw for me.
He's like, hey, you can. You want to come over here? Have a seat.
All right.
Have a seat. Come here, cone.
Come on, everybody loves feet. All right. Giggity, giggity, giggity.
Making love to the cone. And then he admitted it, which was even funnier. Of course, police were called. He was arrested. He pleaded guilty. And...
hey, police? Yeah, it's Quagmire.
There is a violated cone somewhere in Virginia.
It's Quagmire. Yeah. In the cone this time. That's got to be some Everclear stuff, because that's some time traveling drinking.
They don't even make it like that anymore, though.
Oh.
It's much tamer than it was.
Oh, well, then maybe Calico Jack, something, kids. Anything. Thunderbird. There's like iodine and then Thunderbird. It's like a step up. That's a step up above drinking hairspray. My God.
So.
How do you even become? Let me see how I can legally say this. How can you legally get prepared to perform?
Hey.
With a cone.
You just got maybe it had just enough shine.
My talent roster, you know, there's some less than stellar players on my roster. However, I've never looked at a cone and said, well, I got to get me some of that.
I've
woken up the next day or at least 5 o'clock in the morning. And
you're not Trevor Smith, dude. I don't know what to tell you.
I've woken up next to a traffic cone.
Huh?
I've woken up next to a traffic cone before.
Was it in jail, or did you just
It was in my bed. Like, it was just there.
See, I have a similar story to that. I was drinking with my brother one time, and my brother, Rob, is like a crow. He finds things and collects things and sells them and buys them and...
Robbie's a wild man.
He's a junk collector. He has so much stuff. So one day he was living with me, comes home with a 6 foot tall nutcracker, two of them actually, and they were scary. God, 6 foot tall nutcracker.
Well, that sounds like one of the
that's
girls
stuff
I've dated.
Of nightmares I'd are that. Made of. Well, and he knew I was afraid of them and everything. We went out drinking, and I went home and passed out one night, and I woke up with one of them in my bed.
What?
Yeah.
One of the nutcracker. Oh, dude, a 6 foot nutcracker. Yeah.
As tall as I am.
First of all, you had to be hammered for them to carry a 6 foot tall nutcracker into the bed.
When I'm asleep, you could drop you could light fireworks off next to me. I'm not hearing anything.
Well, especially if you've been drinking. If you've been,
regardless. I could just have regardless. Pizza and fell asleep. But, yeah, so.
Chicken Alfredo. Just that's it. My God, I can't, like. Yeah, but you wake up next to that and you see that face. Is it like the bearded face? Is it like one of the nutcrackers?
Again,
like
not the worst face I've ever woken up to.
It looks like a soldier. It had,
yeah,
but
it's
the uniform
same thing.
Was
it's
blue.
The same exact thing.
Yeah, it has a helmet on and a blue uniform.
Well, some nutcrackers, they have...
They're red,
they're
some
like,
of them.
They're like Pez dispensers. Some nutcrackers are like Pez dispensers.
Do they well, open not, so what you're saying is they open their mouths.
The mouth is the nutcracker, Brett.
He learned that the hard way.
Yeah, I was going to say my talent roster.
And I was wondering why I woke up with... Splinter. Never mind.
Yeah.
Never
yeah, go
mind.
Ahead. Finish the sentence, TD.
We're going to go into the topic of the week. What's the craziest drunk purchase you've ever made? And Scott said he has one. You can be a part of the show, 412-407-SHOW. Let us know what your craziest drunk purchase is. Scott, are you off the top of your head? You got any?
It's not really the crazy one. The last thing I bought was this for my cousins, some nice Marvel sweatshirts. Just out of nowhere, my buddy showed up, showed me on his phone. I was like, oh, I want two of those, and just bought them right there. Just no questions asked. I have no idea how much they were. Not a clue. Also didn't fit because I ordered them a small.
Yeah, I hate ordering stuff online sober. I ordered a Mighty Mix gym shirt. It was 3X, and it was it would have been tight on Brett.
Wow, that's saying
I
something,
I always
buddy.
Give Brett my purchases from Wish when I try to buy clothes on Wish.
Yeah, I got my Bullet Club shirt. I
They're
wear it
my
all the
size,
time.
And I give them to Brett because they don't fit me.
Yeah.
So let's
stylish.
So some of the people responded, like on Facebook and some of our other social medias and our emails and stuff. Aaron L. bought a rainbow colored cross-stitch pattern of David Bowie's face, following a $200 worth of supplies, and she had no idea how to cross-stitch.
Whoa.
Yeah.
I could see that being drunk and thinking, oh, hey, how hard is it? It's cross-stitch. You just tie a knot around the strings that are going up.
Isn't
there.
That how you make, like, pot holders and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah. This guy this girl Natalie R, with her brother, drunk one night, bought $180 worth of fake urine. They drank and were discussing it for an hour. In the end, it seemed like a good idea. Now they just have a lot of fake pee. I wonder if you could drink fake pee.
Bring it on the show. I'll experiment.
I know.
Right, this is the kind of stuff you wanted.
Bring some fake pee next
fake
time,
pee.
Scott.
Yeah,
if it's cold enough, I'll drink fake pee.
Bridget,
I will bring you
Bridget
lots
messaged
of fake
us
pee.
On Facebook and said it was not her, but it was her friend.
That's what they all say.
Absurdly drunk and ordered things on Amazon. It's something she does all the time, and always
naturally.
Gets like a surprise. If it's Prime or whatever, it comes the next day. So she always likes to see what her drunk self
That's
sends her
too.
Sober self. And this time she went over to Top and realized there was like all these charges on her credit card bill. And she sent herself 12 vibrators.
Yeah.
12 vibrators. That's a lot of...
That sounds like a person that went to the grocery store hungry.
I'd be a little intimidated.
You don't go to the grocery store hungry because you're just going to start throwing things in your cart because you're hungry.
Yeah, you do that all the time when you're hammered.
So when she's there, she's feeling something, so she needs to satisfy that.
I don't know.
12 times.
Why do you need? All right.
It's funny you have that segue because I'll give you one because I usually purchase like normal stuff. Like a couple weeks before WrestleMania when Kurt Angle decided it was his last match, and I went on Amazon, bought some Kurt Angle t-shirts. Okay, so I've done like normal stuff. It's funny that you bring up the vibrator, you know, the vibrator situation, because when I was hammered a couple years ago,
last week,
it was Boone's Farm. And I'm not kidding about that part. It was Boone's Farm, and I bought the male version of a toy.
The fleshlight.
It wasn't the fleshlight. It was a lady part. It was a rubber lady part. Thing. It was a, you know, downtown Julie Brown. You know, it had like the felt, like fake felt is hair. And it was, I bought it. I was like, that looks good to me. Get it.
How much
glug,
was it?
Glug, glug, Boone's Farm. What's that?
How much was it?
$29.99.
I can afford that.
Plus tax.
Give me one second, guys.
You're going to actually do it. Go. I'm telling you. Go ahead.
You're,
go nuts.
You're going to go buy that?
I don't know about right now.
Oh, okay.
But there's some other things.
It's a lot of work to enjoy the experience. You don't want to do this. Trust me.
He's still looking for the mythical clitoris, so.
No, it's real. It's real.
I still have never found it.
It's real. It's the female orgasm. That's the myth.
Our buddy Larry, he consumed a bottle of white wine and went on eBay at like 2 a.m. and he bought a goat skull.
Whoa.
For what reason, he does not know. He still has it to this day. Like, when I go visit him, he has the goat skull on a mantle at his house. He wears it with pride.
What is it with people actually wanting, like, skulls? Actual skull and bone skulls. I mean,
like, skulls. I mean, that's what my tattoos are. That's where our show logo
that's
is.
One, no, that's one thing, and I understand that.
I don't know if I'd buy a skull.
But, like an actual skull. I mean, like, look, you're wearing the hat. You're wearing the pirate hat. It's got the head.
I have
the
skull version
crossbones.
Of the pirate's hat, believe
yeah,
it or not.
Yeah, and I mean, like, that's fine. That's all. But, like, what is the fascination with animal skulls, or even, I mean, you can't buy a human skull, but you know, like, why is that?
I think
you
can find one somewhere.
I don't know. I'm not doing that. No way. It was weird enough when I was over in Rome and they walking through the catacombs.
They let you out of the country?
Yeah, it was wild.
They let you back in the country?
I had my passport. I had nothing to worry about. All right, I am a citizen of this country. While I was doing some presidenting, you know, no, I seriously, like, I went over to the Roman catacomb and the catacombs. All they have are these actual human skulls, you know, on either side, and they're stacked up 7-8 feet high, and like, yeah, that was weird. That was weird enough. I just can't imagine why somebody would want an actual human skull. What do you get? Like, why?
Maybe the skull wanted to do selfies for life.
Oh, not a bad one.
Selfies for life
and
beyond.
Not a bad one.
That's going to wrap up our topic segment for the week. Our show topic, you can be a part of it. That's a way for you to be a part of the show. That's your voice. You can comment on our Facebook posts. Send it to our private messages on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. You can email us at idiotradio@net@gmail.com. Or just call or text our anytime line, 412-407-SHOW. Don't forget to include your contact information. If we like your story and want to use it on the air, we may just give you a call and have you tell it yourself. But we got to have one for next week, right, Brett?
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. I can't wait for next week.
Next week's going to be a two-parter. It's going to be
two parts.
Yeah. What song, when you hear it, makes that you absolutely hate it every time you hear it? And then the opposite end of the spectrum, What song, when you hear it, do you absolutely love it?
Ooh.
So it's a two-part show topic for next week. Please,
I'm gonna send
it to us and let us know.
I'm going to have all week to think about this. Like, because I mean, just for the show, just to contribute, I'm gonna come up with the top five on either way, you know, on either side. That, you know, because I can listen to pretty much any kind of music, even a little country. When I worked at a certain country radio station, like, I can listen to pretty much anything. But there are songs that, dear Barbara, I can't. Oh, yeah, I can go positive and negative on this. This ought to be good. What do you think? What do you got? Just off the top of your head, just give me one, because I don't know if you're going to be here next week. Yeah, just give us a pre. He can give us a preview. Just off the top of your head, what do you think?
For the song I really like, or the song I really hate?
Either one.
Either one. Ooh, man. What do you got?
You're putting me on the spot here.
How about one you hate?
One I hate.
Pop music.
Pop music. Oh, man, I don't hate a lot of music.
Okay.
Anything by Justice Bieber.
Justin Bieber is
Justice Bieber. I do not like his music.
All right, let's take our last break, and then when we come back, we're going to talk about everything that's going on trending in TV and movies. We did a lot of movies, so it's really just a couple quick TV stories, and then some songs, and the top five songs of the week, and I think we're going to wrap up and get out of here. It's the Todd DeFazio Show with Brett Paradise.
You know it.
Fill in for Hannah and my buddy Scott.
Filling in forever.
We'll be back.
Just kidding.
We'll be back right after this.
You're listening to Idiot Radio. Taking it to the edge and back.
Looking for a creative idea for meetings, business lunches, and special events? Call Spiels on Wheels, Food Truck and Catering, and take the stress away. For more information, call them at 724-244-9881 or on Facebook at facebook.com/spielson.wheels.
We're back on the Todd DeFazio Show. And while we're on the break, that little short break there, I checked the text message line, and we got a text message on 412-407-JOE, and somebody said, Scott is super cute. And ma'am or sir, I do agree. He is very cute.
Thank you.
Lame. I'm sorry, dude.
Jealous, Brett?
I'm a little jealous right now. I'm not gonna lie. I've been here for months now, and you're getting one show, and you're getting Heath cute. Heath cute.
You need to try harder.
He is though.
He's super cute.
You need to try a little bit harder.
Well, I guess I'm the little guy. You know, I don't know.
Yeah. No.
He's living in a van down by the river. He ain't lying. You know, like, I'm that guy. And I don't, you know.
Hey, you got to own it, man.
He's like, he has like 90s Tourette's. That's like the best way I can describe Brett.
It might be. And it might very well be. I don't know about it. It's huge. It's fantastic. I don't get it.
All right.
Are you saying you don't think I'm cute?
Why are you putting me on this? Don't put me on the spot about
this.
It's
too late.
Okay?
You're
a handsome guy. You need to shave though.
All right, let's start wrapping it up.
Whoa.
It's the best I got.
So, all right, Scott's he's out. We just got a couple TV shows that we're gonna talk about.
Shave.
You know Jane Lynch, right? She's coming out with Cyndi Lauper. They got greenlit by Netflix to come up with a modern-day Golden Girls kind of show. There's no title or anything yet. I don't know if it's going to be a Golden Girls reboot or if it's just going to be basically just the premise of it is Golden Girls for today, and it's her and Cyndi Lauper, and who knows who else will be involved, but it's going to be on Netflix.
I was going to say, who's left? There's nobody. I mean,
it would be like a reboot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cyndi Lauper plays Sophia.
Well, no, it would probably be just new characters. I don't think they would be the original characters, Brett.
Oh, I don't. Well, I mean, that's the way I would tell you. You know, because you're talking about like, well, we were talking about Ghostbusters. I mean, you know.
Well, that's a sequel. That's the third installment of the movie.
Yeah, but I mean, there's
it's not a reboot. The girl version was the reboot.
Right, that was the reboot. So then the Golden Girls would just be a re.
It just may be new characters, new girls, or who knows? It doesn't. And NBC probably owns the rights. I think NBC is the one that did Golden
Girls. See, that's
Girls.
That, yeah, because
or who knows? Somebody else may own it by now. Another reboot that they're talking about, Scott. Did you watch this show, Scott?
I know the show, Saved but I never actually watched it.
You never watched it?
Oh.
I know the show, but I've never watched it.
Well, it seems like everybody's coming out with a streaming service now, a new streaming platform, and NBC Universal, Universal NBC, is coming out with the Peacock. It's going to be their streaming network. And Saved by the Bell Revival, starring the original cast members, Mario Lopez, A.C. Slater, you know, the guy who played A.C. Slater, and Elizabeth Berkley. What movie was she in that?
Showgirls.
Yes. Jesse played Jesse Spano. They're going to be the main characters of this one, and I hope Mr. Belding, if he's still alive, is going to be a part of it.
He's still alive.
I have a feeling Screech is not going to be a part of it. I've heard nothing but bad things about that dude. But this is now like the third or fourth. This is actually the fourth reboot of that show because they had like the college years. Then it was like Screech and Mr. Belding at the school. And then they had like specials where they got married and like the reunion and stuff. So I don't know.
They take a good thing from our childhood.
If the Peacock streaming service is free, I'll get it. But I'm dropping all my streaming services as soon as Disney Plus comes out, Scott.
Yeah, I would do the same.
There is so many good things coming out from Disney Plus.
Well, I mean, so Disney Plus is kind of like one of those networks you can watch anything Disney. Is that what I'm saying?
Disney, Marvel, correct? Star Wars, Fox.
You're not going to need anything else if you get that.
No, you're not.
No.
And what's really nice about all the content for the launch, they have an Obi-Wan Kenobi series coming out. They have some of the lesser characters from the Marvel movie universe will have their own show on.
There's
that.
No such thing as a lesser character.
Well, I was going to say, if they did Ant-Man,
that may not need, you know, that weren't big enough to have their own solo movie. I think I'm even going to probably drop the WWE Network because my kids are going to hate me for that.
Oh, no.
I'm
going to hate you for it.
So, yeah.
Bro.
We watch it
it's
once.
My life.
We watch it once a month, for real.
Well, yeah, for the pay-per-views and stuff. But
and you know what? You know what's funny? Is Fox is owned by Disney, and there's been rumors for many, many years that Disney's been trying to buy the WWE, so this could be the trial run for them to buy.
Oh, boy.
So, you know, Vince ain't getting any younger.
Well, pass it off to somebody else so you can wind it down.
I honestly, you know, maybe this is the trial run. I don't know. I think I just broke Brett's heart by saying that, but
yeah, I'm a little hurt. I'm not gonna lie.
All right, we're gonna do the top.
There's
five.
No crying in the Todd DeFazio show.
Not yet, but there will be
with Hannah and Brett.
You know
you gotta add that extra. So it's the top five songs of the week this week. And
what do we got?
Coming in at number five, we got the Bad Guy song, Billie Eilish. I like this song.
It's catchy.
I was thinking about coming out to this for the wedding. The Bad Guy.
Come out for that one.
What's that?
I thought you were talking about a different coming out for that one.
Oh.
Yeah, he said coming out, and I was like, what?
Then this would have made sense between him and I.
Is this considered singing?
Yeah, man.
No, my favorite song that she does is the one with The Office in it.
I've never heard it.
She has whatever the other one is that's out right now. It's pretty good. I don't have her album or anything. Coming in at number four, Post Malone makes his return with he has multiple songs in the top ten. And at number four, he has this new song called Circles. This is probably the worst song of Post Malone that I've heard. It's very mainstream, don't you think, Scott?
I don't think I like it very much.
I'd go to Brett, but I don't think Brett's not, I don't even know who Post Malone is, bro.
No, no, it's funny you mention that, though, because I saw on Facebook, I saw a status where somebody was talking about who, like, Post Malone did this, and then he looked like this, and then I was like, Post Malone, and I swear to you, I'm not kidding, this shows you how old I am. I said, Post Malone, why are they referencing the Utah Jazz forward? Carl Malone, the mailman, Post Malone. I thought that's what it was. I swear to you, I go, Post Malone, is he a rapper now?
I've seen a...
I'm not noticing the age gap between the three of us.
Well, I'm the oldest.
Yeah, he got five on me.
I seen a funny meme the other day for Post Malone. It was Post Stallone, and somebody put Sylvester Stallone's face where...
Oh, my
Post
God.
Malone, I even put the tattoos on. It's pretty funny, I thought. back to the countdown, top five songs of the week. Number three song, Post coming in again at Post Malone with Goodbye. Now, I like this song better than that Circle song. I want you out of my head. He's gotten very mainstream. I play this for Scott all the time.
Is this how it goes the whole time?
It's a slower song, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then Todd likes to keep to the beat of that one when him and I are together.
You're supposed to like eat ice cream and look at your ex's Facebook status or something. Sounds like one of those kind of deals.
Yeah, maybe.
Like, you know, like it's like right up there with Adele. You know, like.
Well, coming in.
I now have my top five for next week.
Number two, Senorita, Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello. Is that her name, Scott?
Rapido
Caballo?
Yeah,
no clue. Not a clue.
She's hot. I know that.
I have no idea who she is.
I know this song got really big when they did it at the MTV Music Awards. I was like, whatever. I didn't know anybody.
This song does nothing for me.
You wouldn't play this for like a Tinder date or anything?
Oh, God, no.
That's some salsa dancing stuff right there.
Like, oh, man. Come on over and dance.
Yeah, you could fake salsa dance. Yeah, I mean, you can do that.
If you guys want to have me back on the show, I will tell you some Tinder
stories. We should take you to the Linden Grove one day.
Oh, God, I've heard about that place.
The Cougar Castle.
I hear that's where people go to die.
The Cougar Capital of the world.
Oh, the Cougar Capital. We got to send our young buck over here.
I did that one time with
Mike me up for that bad boy.
I did that with my younger brother. My stepbrother turned 21. We took him there. And the ladies were attacking.
So, meow.
So this strapping young man, it may be bad for you, sir. And here it is, the number, which I am not fond of this song either. It's what, second or third week on the charts. Dethroned Old Town Road. Truth Hurts, Lizzo. I hate this song.
And now we found Todd's top five.
This is the song that I hate when I hear. And I hate Cardi B though too.
God, I hate Cardi B.
So that's our top five songs of the week. And I think
I didn't even recognize that number one. I didn't.
Oh, they play it.
I've heard it.
You don't listen to the radio, dude.
It's just anytime I hear a ridiculous booming bass with the typical backbeat.
This is Brett's number one song on his charts. Ready? You ready, Scott?
I'm ready for it.
It's yeah.
That's his countdown right there. When it comes crashing down.
Well, let me tell you something, brother. Yeah, me too.
I think it's going to wrap up the Todd DeFazio show.
Woo!
Today.
We're going out on a high note, brother.
Todd DeFazio show with Brett and Hannah. Yeah, filling in for Hannah. Thanks to my buddy Scott. It's always nice when my drinking partner comes in and we hang out.
This is where the power lies, brother.
Don't forget to check out Bubba, my buddy Bubba Brewer. Triple B Experience, all the other shows on idiotradio.net. It's the Todd DeFazio show. We're getting out of here before Brett breaks stuff. Thanks for listening.
We got to end every show like this.